I'm Tom Kading. Today I'm going to continue talking about some of the good practices out there to follow when starting a company. These are essentially practices to ensure your entity's liability protection does not fail. So these practices also could apply to other entities that don't have liability protection, such as partnerships or sole proprietors. But in those cases, these practices wouldn't necessarily affect piercing the corporate veil, as it's tradition called. So what is breaching the corporate veil? To understand this, you need to understand that in an entity such as a limited liability company or an LLC, the owner is not personally liable for anything the company cannot pay for, but there is a few basic ways the owner can be held liable for the company's liabilities. These typically relate to personal guarantees, piercing the corporate veil, proper payouts, and certain types of fraud. The top things I would recommend to not get caught in this trap would include, first off, don't commit fraud. Maintain separate identities for the company and yourself. This means you have to have a separate bank account for each company. Do not buy personal stuff with the entity, and don't take other action that might blur that line. Put a reasonable amount of funds in the company initially. Don't pay for things personally. The company should always pay. Follow corporate formalities such as meeting minutes, signing loan docs, and sign on behalf of the company. I know this could be annoying to always write your title after your name, but it's an important formality to distinguish what you do as a person versus a company. The final thing I would recommend that isn't specifically piercing the corporate veil is purchasing D&O insurance or directors and officer insurance. It can be a safeguard if the company gets sued and the plaintiff decides to name the owner, even if that claim is totally unjust. Again, this is Tom Kading.